Assalamu alaikum dear friends, this is Sajid Ali. In this lecture we are going to discuss about the decline of Mughal Empire. So in my previous lecture we discussed the emperor of Aurangzeb. He was also the emperor of Mughal Empire, and after Aurangzeb the remaining rulers of Mughal Empire were weak. That's why they changed soon. So Bahadur Shah I, he was the son of Aurangzeb, and before the death of Aurangzeb he himself divided his empire into his three sons, their names Mozam, Azam and Kambaksh. So dear friends, Mozam got Kabul and Punjab. Azam got Gujarat and Malwa. Kambaksh, he got Dakhan. In this way Aurangzeb divided his empire into three sons. Even then his sons fought with each other to become a single ruler of Mughal Empire. So dear friends, they three brothers, the sons of Aurangzeb, fought one another, and as Mozam defeated his two brothers and killed them. After that he became a single ruler of Mughal Empire and assumed the title Bahadur Shah I. He ruled from 1707 to 1712. After Bahadur Shah I, Jandar Shah from 1712 to 1713, and Farukh Siyar from 1713 to 1719. Muhammad Shah was from 1719 to 1748. Then Ahmad Shah was the successor of Muhammad Shah. He was the son of Muhammad Shah Alamgir II, Shah Alam, Akbar II and Bahadur Shah II. Bahadur Shah Zafar, his complete name. Bahadur Shah II was the last ruler of Mughal Empire, and after the War of Independence Mughal Empire was ended and Bahadur Shah Zafar sent to an exile to Rangoon. So dear friends, in this way Mughal rulers ruled, and what was the limited empire? Due to their weakness Mughal empire became small. So many regions became independent. Odh, Bihar, Bengal, Odisha, Dakhan, Rajputs and Rohilkhand and other areas became independent. That's why the vast Mughal area became small and weak. So Odh became independent under Saadat Khan. Now Saadat Khan was the ruler of Odh. Bihar, Bengal, Odisha was under Ali Wardi Khan. Dakhan was under Asaf and Nizamul Mulk. Rajputs also became independent and Rohilkhand under Rohilas. So dear friends, in this way Mughal Empire became short and small. And what were the main causes of decline of Mughal Empire? No law of accession. There was no any kind of ascended the throne. As I discussed with you in different lectures, Mughal rulers fought with each other to become rulers of Mughal Empire, and brothers, even son and father, to become a single ruler to get power. So dear friends, no any kind of proper law of accession in Mughal Empire. That's why it was the main cause behind the decline of Mughal Empire and fall of Mughal Empire. Marathas, they were extreme enemies of Mughals, especially after Aurangzeb, because Aurangzeb created only enemies and he introduced such kind of policies which were against other religions, and majority of non-Muslims living in India, as I already told you. Marathas were the main causes. They fought against Mughal Empire till the War of Independence, till the end of Mughal Empire. Nader Shah was the ruler of Persia, now Iran. He attacked in India in 1739 when Muhammad Shah was the ruler of Mughal Empire. So dear friends, when Nader Shah attacked in India, he took with himself so many precious things from India to his own empire, to decorate and to develop his own empire at Persia. He took with himself so many skilled persons, just like masons, carpenters, goldsmiths, blacksmiths, and jewelries, and so many other resources from subcontinent India. He also took with himself the peacock throne, which was made by Shah Jahan. It was also one of the major and precious thing in the Mughal Empire. After the invasion of Nader Shah, Mughal Empire became so weak, because Mughal emperors became bankrupt and they economically weak, and now they had no any good army and weapons to fight with their enemies, to face different challenges, and now they are bankrupt. So dear friends, after the invasion of Nader Shah, Mughal Empire, the sign of weaknesses. The third battle of Panipat was fought in 1761 between Marathas and Ahmad Shah Abdali. Ahmad Shah Abdali was a ruler of Afghanistan. He came to India on the invitation of Shah Wali Ullah to crush Marathas and their powers. This is a symbol and sign of weakness. How the ruler of other areas attacked on India, it was the weak sign of Mughal emperors. They could not secure and save their people, their public, and even their state, their government. So dear friends, the third battle of Panipat was also the sign of weakness of Mughal Empire. Interfere of European. At first, European came to India for trade, and they established a company named East India Company. At the time of Jahangir, so dear friends, British came to India for the purpose of trade, but slowly and gradually they occupied different areas. They gave loans to the Mughal emperors, and the East India Company became the ruling company over India. And in this way, after the War of Independence in 1857, after the war of independence. In 1857, East India Company was invaded and British United Kingdom directly governed over India, and they invaded the vast government and empire of Mughals. In this way, Mughals were finished, and the new dynasty, the new empire was started, British Empire. So dear friends, inshallah, in future we will discuss about British, how they came and why they came, and in this way also we discussed about Mughals, what were Mughals, how they ruled over India, and how they created their enemies, what were the reasons behind the fall of Mughal Empire. Thank you very much, dear friends. Inshallah, we will discuss about British government in future in my next lecture. Take care. Allah Hafiz.